Hi, I'm Paul Darley, and thanks for tuning into our September issue of Inside Darley. FAMA, that's the Fire Apparatus Manufacturers Association, just released their statistics on new fire truck orders through the end of June for 2017, and overall, the news was good. Comparing it to the same period for 2016, new orders for fire apparatus in the United States are up about 18%, and they're up about 40% in Canada, so that's great news for those of us who serve the fire service. We've also been members of NFPA, that's the National Fire Protection Association, for a long time. In fact, four of our employees serve on different NFPA committees, and their July-August issue of the NFPA Journal was just excellent. We've attached two articles for you. The first is Firefighter Fatalities in the United States. It was put together by Rita Fahey as well as some others there, and it took a very detailed look at this. And in fact, in 2016, there were 69 fatalities, which is obviously one is too many, but comparing to the last 5 years, there were 73 fatalities on average, so that was below the average. And just 10 years ago, we were always looking to be under 100 deaths per year. So we as a fire service are heading in the right direction. Of those 69 deaths, 39 of them came from volunteer departments, 19 from career departments, and 8 from U.S. federal government agencies. 29 of those deaths were related to heart attacks or cardiovascular issues, and 17 of those were either responding to or returning from the fire. The second article in this NFPA journal that was just great was called Shrinking Resources, Growing Concerns, and it was directed at volunteer fire departments and the challenges that they're having with finding volunteers and funding and all, and in fact, their volunteers are roughly down 20% over the last 5 years, and it's at a time when these fire departments are facing more fires per capita than any other type of fire department. So as you look at volunteer departments who serve a community of 2,500 or less, they're three times more, they have three times more fires than per capita than larger cities, and 2.5 times more than the national average. So, and another issue that's plaguing both of these is both volunteer and career firefighters is that of cancer, and we'll take a close look at that at a future issue of Inside Darley. You know, as a company, we're investing heavily in water, both whether it's water purification, water distribution. We see it as a major crisis and a mega trend, both in the world as well as in the United States. And we've attached here as our third attachment a Darley Water Capability Statement. And one of the areas where we're really doing quite well that might be a surprise to you, and it might even sound a little odd, is water in a box. And just so you may have be familiar with wine in a box, for example, it's kind of the same concept, and it's really taken off for a variety of reasons. Number one, you know, there no air can get into the bag, so it has a longer shelf life than water inside of bottles. Number two, it's stackable, and it takes up a lot less space than water in a bottle. And lastly, from a pollution or an environmental standpoint, you don't have all the bottles that you're dealing with. And one of our customers, in particular, the U.S. Army, has really grabbed a hold of this. And for deploying water either for humanitarian reasons or to our own troops, they just very successfully dropped our boxes of water through a C-130. I think you'll find that, as they have, it's a great way for them to save money while addressing a major concern for our soldiers, which is water. We are not having our H2O water golf outing this year, but we are continuing to support different charities throughout the world, as we have in Nepal and Cuba, and this year we're off to Tanzania to donate some water purification systems. And if you have a couple of minutes, check out this trailer video with Kevin Sofen that shows some of our corporate social responsibilities as it relates to water. So thanks for tuning into this issue of Inside Darley. If there's anything we can be doing to support you, we hope you'll reach out to us.
When this hospital opens in about 2 months, it will be the only building, not just hospital, but the only building in all of Kathmandu that 5 million people live in, where every faucet that you open would be as if you were in the United States. Every shower, every faucet, every operating room, every clinic in this hospital will have safe drinking water to the standards of the US EPA.